I come from Canterbury. Some of you may know the city in Kent. And there's a local character in Canterbury. And I've been aware of this woman. I know nothing about this woman. I have a habit, it seems, of when I'm not touring, or even when I am touring, when I have any spare time, I sit outside coffee shops and I people watch. I don't know if that's a weird thing to do, whether any of you guys do it, but I just enjoy people watching. And I have a habit of if someone looks as if they tell a story, I have a habit of then going and writing songs about them. Although I know nothing of them, people fall victim of this. And Aunt Sally is one of these people. Now, Aunt Sally is known to everyone as Aunt Sally because she does her cheeks up in the same way as Aunt Sally from Wurzel Gummidge. And she's quite the character. And for years I've been wanting to write a song about her, but never really knew what exactly to say until the idea that sparked this song was the closing down of my secondary school. Now, the reason for the closing down for my secondary school was just, it was a dreadful school. I'm not sure who it is, whether it's the council or the government. The guys that come along and take a look at schools and go, okay, we see this school's in trouble, you're not doing so well. What we're gonna do is we're gonna throw a load of money at the school. We're gonna give all the kids an iPad. All of a sudden they're just gonna behave. And we're gonna call this school an academy instead. But those guys, whoever they are, they came along to have a look at the school and they went, oh, now we give it a miss. It's just a big empty building now. And it's been in this state for the last couple of years, but soon after that happened and all the kids left, rumours started flying around town that there were people using the school for shelter, there were people squatting at the school. And ever since hearing that, I seem to see Aunt Sally lingering about an awful lot, looking shifty outside my school. And I was driving past one day when all these bizarre thoughts started coming into my head. I thought, ah, what if she's in there using my school for shelter? What if she's in one of my old English rooms? What if she's found one of my old English essays? What if she's marking it? But I thought, well, that's a good idea for a song. So as soon as I got back, I started writing this. It talks about that. But it also talks a bit about how, ever since being a kid, first started going into town with my parents and all of that, she always seemed to be in a state where she needed a bit of help, and for some reason or another, never really seemed to receive that. But anyway, this is Aunt Sally.
Old Aunt Sally said her head is spinning, she's struggling to see a thing. Said it's something she ate, but I reckon it's the pills and all the drink. Aunt Sally's feeling blue, Aunt Sally's feeling grey. Yeah, since she's been feeling in the pink. Old Aunt Sally is singing now as the medication takes its toll. Street of her hometown, she's searching for some rock and roll. Powdered her nose in the cubicle and is ready to explode. Yeah, since anybody's cared to know, I sold her down a river on a raft of broken dreams. Potions, lies, and pills and schemes. Told her she was better off, but that ain't what it seems. As Aunt Sally screams, wow. Raining, it's pouring, Sally's snoring, made bass in the closed down school. She got kicked out of her home, her house now sleeps in my old English room. Oh, times are hard, but she ain't no quitter. Been years since she's been feeling chipper. Yes. Down a river on a raft of broken dreams. Filled her up with potions, lies, and pills and schemes. Yeah. Sally is feeling queasy. Looks like she's coming down. Paid for a trip, guess that was it. What will she do now? Aunt Sally's feeling blue. Aunt Sally's feeling grey. But Aunt Sally's gotten used to it. It's just another day. See you.